sure you have noticed that the Vietnamese food is very popular recently. But did you know what's behind this popular classic dish? Who came up with the recipe for a good coffee, which first have been toasted in the digestive system of a weasel? What the French colonialism did to the Vietnamese kitchen and society? We will try to find out next. So do not forget to click on the bell and subscribe Foodie Eyes. We are starting right now. The French, who intermittently ruled for 150 years in Vietnam, brought with them the Western progress and the modernization, until they had to be deported in a terrible war led by the Communist Party and its founder Ho Chi Minh, who acted surprisingly from Paris, where all the process of modernity occurred at that time. Today, if you go to New York or Paris, you will find that the Vietnamese restaurants have become very popular. There we can find several traditional classic dishes. For example, pho bò. This is the familiar noodle soup, obtained in Vietnam as a traditional noodle soup. It is a soup based on the beef bones axis. But when did they start eating meat in Vietnam? When the French came. Before that, no meat was eaten in Vietnam. In the South and East Asia region, there is a taboo about eating beef, similar to that in India, and also because bovine are perceived as a work animals and not as animals intended for eating. And here the French appear with the cow. In Vietnamese, the word cow is. And if you will ask a Vietnam guy about this word, he might tell you that this specific word is because the animal does so, meaning it does bò. But obviously, bò appears from the French word bovin. So this soup's name is pho. But the truth about this land is that it is the French name pot-au-feu, which is a classic French country beef soup. And here we have a plate of soup from the axis of the bones, a French cooking method to all opinions, and with local vegetables and noodles. And it is considered a traditional Vietnamese dish. In fact, this is a dish invented 100 years ago by the private chef of some French colonial. What else did the French bring to Vietnam? Coffee. The coffee shop is a critical institution in the Vietnamese life. Almost every Vietnamese meets at least once a day in his coffee shop. Of course, the coffee shops comes along with the cafe, which is a distinctly French institution, which the Vietnamese adopt and later had turned into a subversive arena from which they act against the French occupation. Today, Vietnam is the second largest coffee exporter in the world, after Brazil. One of the interesting things that happened was one special, and that is the coffee whose initial processing was done in the intestines of a weasel. And it goes like this. Coffee beans are made of sweet layers, and inside there is the nucleus. That is our coffee. They give it to a weasel who eats the coffee. Enzymes in the weasel's stomach fluids ferment the beans and neutralize them from their natural bitterness and sourness. The beans, which the weasel cannot digest, emerge from the intestines of the weasel. Then the workers collect the coffee beans, clean them from the shit, and toast them in a unique method. This is the most expensive coffee in the world, and I do not know who came up with this recipe. When the Vietnamese heard that the white man was willing to pay a lot of money in return for a coffee that comes out of a weasel's ass, they built farms with thousands of ferrets in order to feed them with coffee beans and break the world's market of fine coffee. And in Vietnamese, this coffee is called chun, and it is worth knowing that the Vietnamese meaning for this word is ass. The third thing the French brought was milk, and this happens and gets new power in the recent decades because south of Asia region never consumed milk at all. Milk is the secretion of the cow, and as such it is repulsive, just like blood and pus. Until the 90s, not long ago, milk consumption in Vietnam was very low, and there was no asthma, arthritis or acne. Today there is a tremendous effort by all the countries that raise cows for milking to transfer the dairies to east of Asia. And that's because there is a clear understanding that consumption of milk and dairy products in general, and other products which made from cows, not only does not nourish as they thought, but it also harms and creates diversity troubling problems that are growing. This is really unhealthy, and milk consumption is going down in the West. And there is an urgent need to find new markets. So, the milk manufacturers are arriving to the Chinese and the Vietnamese and tell them, want to be tall as we are, powerful as we are, white like us, smart like us? There you are, dear one. Drink milk. And the industrial cowsheds are being moved to Asia. And maybe it seems that the tag of price for this new consumption is coming very soon. And that is the reason I remind you to subscribe this channel and get the best foodie videos on your main screen. Thanks for watching. See ya on the next.